Now, the journey for the Greek superstar wasn't always an easy one. He was raised in a very poor family. He'd only been playing basketball competitively for 5 years when Milwaukee drafted him back in 2013. Adam Duxter now live from Milwaukee to explain how those humble beginnings forever tied him to one lifelong fan. Adam?
Well, these days, Giannis is arguably the most recognizable person in the entire state of Wisconsin. But in November 2013, he was just a kid in need of a ride, recognized by one person, turning into a car ride Jane Gallup will never forget.
It's impossible to describe the Milwaukee Bucks without their 6'11 superstar.
Oh, I think he means everything to the city. I mean, I just think he means so much.
But before he was the Greek freak, Jane Gallup knew Giannis Antetokounmpo as the Bucks rookie who had the potential.
And I am an optimist, and I think this guy, he's gonna be it.
But didn't have the car.
So it's November. It's like November 20th, 18th, or something like that. First cold day of the season. We're out shopping and I see, like two blocks away, I see a very tall person running. And I think, looks like might be Giannis. He is running and he's wearing jeans and a windbreaker and it is 18 degrees out. And I say, can we offer him a ride? He says, sure. He climbs into the backseat of our car and we have a really little car. We have a Honda Fit, right?
Yeah.
So he's, and he's sitting in the back seat, all like, folded, like his knees up to his chin.
Back in 2013, the 6'9", 18-year-old was still working on his English when he explained he was leaving the Western Union where he'd just sent his paycheck to his family back home. With no car and no cash, he told Gallup he planned to run 3 miles to the Bradley Center. She wasn't having it.
I say, you've got to wear a winter jacket. This is my concern. I'm old enough to be his mother.
And neither were his coaches.
An assistant coach who was watching as we dropped him off. Right, watching some strangers drop off their new rookie who was like, you know, the hopes of the franchise. And they say to him, who was that? He said, I don't know, but they were very nice. And they said, in America, you cannot take rides with strangers. So he never did again. So
today, Gallup still drives that car.
Sideways, knees to chin. I mean, it's the only way he could have fit in.
And while the back seat is just as small, her love for Giannis hasn't stopped growing. The mom in her, proud to see the man the lanky teen she once chauffeured has become.
I feel like he's my long-lost son.
And as Giannis got out of the car that day, he signed Gallup, who is a UW Milwaukee professor, two autographs, one in English and one in Greek. And to add just another layer to this already wild story, Gallup just got back to America today from Scotland, where she's been visiting her son, and she's been watching every single Bucks playoff game in Scottish time. So she's been waking up at 2 in the morning to watch the Bucks compete, including yesterday, 2 a.m. to watch them take home the NBA championship. And again, she said she feels almost like a proud parent in this scenario.
That is a great story. Good find there. Adam Duxter live outside Fiserv Forum. Adam, thank you.